again, I hate to generalize, but I think for a lot of women, Me Too is a part of their life story, right? It's not just some one moment. For a lot of women, it's part of a lot of small and big moments that happen to us through our lifetimes that can be categorized as Me Too, right? And it really informs our story. It informs certainly the way we view our sexuality and the way we act as sexual beings in the world. So for men, sexual shame, profound, pervasive, deep sexual shame is a part of their story. Because like I mentioned before, male sexuality is used to control men in certain ways, to demand things from men, to pressure them to perform in a certain way. And by the way, that performance pressure is what they carry with them throughout their lifetimes, and they certainly bring it into the bedroom a lot. And so if we want to talk to men, if we want to connect to men, we need to understand and that their story is oftentimes informed by struggles with sexual shame and many instances where they felt that their sexuality was out of bounds, perverted, gross, you name it, right? I mentioned the languaging that exists around it, right? And so where I think my job gives me this wonderful advantage is because both my training and both the way that I work with men is very much based on creating a safe space and really removing shame from the conversation and creating a space that is accepting of them, whoever they are, wherever they are in this moment, right? And so I think that creates then an opportunity to have a conversation. When they feel like they won't get shamed, they won't get rejected or judged, they become a lot more open to acknowledging some very difficult truths. But when you tell a man that there's something wrong with him, that he's dirty or gross or just because he's a man, it creates an immediate defensive reaction. And unfortunately, it's not productive, right?
Yeah.
So that's something I really wanted to draw attention to.